Now, for the measurement, we can actually activate this button called gate. Alright. Now, with this gate being activated, we can actually start doing the measurement. This button is actually for us to select which gate. Actually, we can have more than one gate to do the measurement. Allow me to show you by selecting this button first, because I want to show you how we can move this gate. Okay. Now, this reading show at which position that we actually started the measurement. Okay. Now, we can also adjust the width if you want to. Okay. Right. You can see that. Whatever width between this range within this gate, it will measure and display the reading here. And now right now you can see the reading is not tally, because for a simple reason it's not measuring anything. Okay, so you want to move this to here to do the measurement. Yes, we can do so. Say we press this start button and then we move it over here. Okay, so right now it is actually showing us the range of this pulse is 100 mm. 100 mm means what? It is actually the thickness of our test block. You know, our this meter has been calibrated, so it's actually accurately showing what is the thickness of the test block thickness. Okay. Now, the next one I wish to show you is that, oh, by the way, have I show you this threshold? Threshold is something allow us to move up and down for the gate. Okay, right? Now, 50% meaning halfway through the screen. Okay, right? Higher, more, lower than 50%. This is it actually showing in terms of percentage of the height. Alright. Now press another one time. This logic, positive logic means simply means that this actually work together with this alarm setting. Okay, so I turn on this alarm, you may get this sound. Why? Because this pulse and really exceed this gate for the monitoring purpose. Okay. Should I reduce this pulse? What does it mean? You see, the moment your signal strength lower than this gate, the alarm is actually off. What happened is actually more than that. Okay. Now this gate here work as not just for measurement purpose, it also work as a monitoring purpose. Monitor for what? Monitor whether or not the floor is bigger than expected. Okay. Now, when the floor is bigger than expected, usually the pulse will be larger. Okay, the amplitude is going to be higher. All right. Now, we can also select for negative. Okay, negative means what? It's actually the opposite of positive. Meaning, the floor lower than the expected, then it actually let us know. Okay. Right. What is next? Multi. Okay, this is what I'm talking about. That is, we can actually set the gate more than one. Alright, so allow me to show you. Okay, meaning over here we can actually select either A or B. You can see that already. Okay, now, so I'm going to move B, then I just press start. Okay, right now, what I'm moving is actually B gate. Okay, so I'm going to change to A. I change to A, then I press this last start button. Right now, what I'm moving is actually A gate. Okay, right. If you are not using the alarm, the monitoring purpose, it will be best for us to turn it off. Okay, right. Now, let's go to the next one. Now, this auto AT, you know, it's actually a very important features for some monitoring purpose. Why? Because the moment we actually turn it on, it will automatically increase or decrease the gain, so that the pulse display is actually occupying 80% of the screen. Once it is 80% of the screen, right, then it will actually stop automatically. But because in this case it's actually unstable, probably I should hold it, make it become stable, then it will turn off. Meaning after you achieve stable 80% of the screen height, right, then it will off by itself. Okay. Now,